Welcome to Strengthened Materials Lab, Department of Mechanical Engineering, IIT Guwahati. So today I will explain to you how to find out the principal stresses in a photoelastic material using the photoelastic method. So for that we will be using the equipment which is known as the research like polariscope. So let me explain to you about the various components of the equipment. So in a research light polariscope, the main component is the source of light. So as you can see within this box, we have two different lighting systems. So if we open this cover, we will be seeing the two sources of light. So these are the sources of light. This is the halogen lamp, which will give you the monochromatic light. And this is a simply tube light. This will give you the white light. So this tube light will give you the white light. And this monochromatic light will give, this halogen lamp will give you the monochromatic light for the polarizer. So these are the switches for the light. This is the switch for the halogen lamp and this is the switch for the white light. And here is a fan for cooling. You have to switch on any one of this light and the fan. Then we have the polarizer. This is the polarizer plate. These are a set of lenses and this is the analyzer. This is also another set of lenses. This is the analyzer. And then we have the loading unit. This is the loading unit where we will be applying load in the photoelastic materials. So in your experiment we will give you this sort of a material. This is a photoelastic material in which we will mark some points. At those points you have to find out the principal stress. So that is a part of your BTech lab. So these are some photoelastic materials. These are some transparent materials. Photoelastic materials, this is another one. So photoelastic materials, they are based upon a unique property of some transparent materials, in particular certain plastics. This property is known as Baer-Fingen property. So in a model of some structural part made from a photoelastic material, when the model is stressed and a ray of light enters the sample, two phenomena takes place. First of all, at each point of the stress body, the light wave is resolved into two mutually perpendicular components lying in the planes of the principal stresses occurring at that point. And secondly, the linear velocity of each of the component of light wave is retarded to the stress specimen in direct proportion to the difference in the principal stresses. So this is the property based on which we can find out the principal stresses in a photoelastic material. So now let us place this specimen for loading. So the sample is being placed for loading. So as you can see below, there are two supports on which the sample will be placed. And the upper portion, as you can see, this portion, this is the loading point. There are two loading points. We will apply the load at two points through a lever system. So now let us see how the load is applied. So this is a load hanger. Presently there is a load of 5 kg on the hanger. So this load is transmitted through this lever to the sample. So as you can see, this is the lever system through which the load is being transferred to your sample. So this is the sample and these two are the points of loading through which the 5 kg load is applied. And this is the fulcrum point of the lever. And this is the balancing load. So now if you have the dimensions of this specimen, this is a simple rectangular specimen. If you know the thickness, width, height, everything of this specimen, and if I give you the load, that is the 5 kg load, and if I give you the dimensions of this lever, what is the distance of the fulcrum to the loading point, and all this distance, if I give you, what is the distance of this loading point, this distance of this loading point from the this load tray, all these dimensions, if you can, if I give you, then you will be able to calculate the a load applied at any point in this specimen by drawing a free body diagram and a bending moment diagram. So that is how you can calculate the theoretical load in the specimen. Now let us see how to determine that principal stresses at any two points in the specimen with the help of this polariscope. So if you observe the polarized light passing through the specimen and if you observe it through the analyzer, then you can see there are fringe patterns occurring on the specimen. As you can see, these are the fringe patterns that are occurring on the specimen due to the polarized light passing through the stressed specimen. Now those fringe patterns that you can see, these are called isoclinic and isochromatic lines. So the isochromatic, whether you want the isochromatic lines or the only the isoclinic lines, that can be set up using the analyzer plates and the polarizer plates. So you can see there are points in this plate where you can, this is a knob. By rotating this knob, you can arrange the angle of the plate. Similarly, there is a knob in the polarizer plate also. So this is the knob. Now you see in the analyzer plate, in the polarizer plate, there is a level marked as D, and there is a knob here. If you attach that knob to the D configuration, then you will get the plane polariscope. That means you will see both the isoclinics and the isochromatic lines. Now if you observe, you can see there is another point marked as M. If you fit this knob in the slot marked as M, this is the M, then it will be set as circular polariscope, where you can see only the isochromatic lines. So isochromatic lines will signify the magnitude of stress, whereas isoclinics signify the direction of stress. But in this experiment we need only the magnitude, so we have to set it to MM configuration so that you get only the isochromatics for no confusion. So now we are applying 5 kg of load through this lever to the specimen. This is the specimen. So now if you observe the fringe patterns, we can see those are the black and white fringe patterns. So the pattern that is passing through the center of the specimen will be the neutral axis, and the fringe pattern that is number one above the neutral axis is the fringe pattern order number one, and above that, that is two in this way. Similarly, the fringe pattern just below the neutral axis will be the fringe pattern order number one, and the one that is still lower will be number two. In this way, we go on towards the end. So now for your experiment, we will mark two or three points like this. So you have to place your specimen in the equipment, pass the polarized light, and see which fringe order passes through these points. Suppose the fringe order 1 passes through the point 1, so then you have to write in your table that fringe order number 1 is passing through the point. So this has some significance which I will tell you now. So these are some of the properties of your sample, dimensions of your sample that you have to note down. So as you can see, thickness, height, moment of inertia, L1, L2, these will be given to you. These are the distances of the fulcrum from the loading point, or the distances of the loading unit, or the distances from the load to the loading point. These values will be given to you, and P is the load that we are placing in the pan, and all these values will be given to you. So you have to fill up this table from your experimental data, like the sampling point 1 and 2. If you apply 5 kg, what is the fringe order that is passing through the point 1, and what is the fringe order that is passing through the point 2. Similarly, at some other load like 13 kg, you have to again find out the fringe order number that is passing through point 1 and another one at point 2. Now this is the formula that you have to apply for your observation. Sigma 1 minus sigma 2 equal to Fn divided by T. So sigma 1 minus sigma 2 is the principal stresses. In this case, your load is applied only in the perpendicular direction, so sigma 2 will be 0, sigma 1 will be equal to Fn by T, and F is the stress optical coefficient for this special for this specific material, the value of which will be given to you. T is the thickness that also will be given to you, and you will observe through the experiment what is the fringe order number. In this way, you can very easily calculate stress sigma 1. And by drawing the free body diagram of the loading unit and the specimen, you can also find out the theoretical values of sigma 1. So you have to compare your theoretical results and experimental results and gives your conclusion. So this is what you have to do in this experiment. So we will give you this full manual so that you will have a brief idea of what is the photoelasticity is all about, a little bit of theory about photoelasticity, about isoclinics and isochromatics we will give you. Also a little bit how to draw the free body diagram in this way. So you have to read this report, you have to read this laboratory handout and then finally you have to answer this, you have to fill up these tables and give your inference, sources of error, etc., and then submit the report. Thank you.